China is set to unveil its rival to Starship, a powerful rocket called the Zhu-3. Its incredible potential has captivated many around the world, including Elon Musk, who has recognized its impressive attributes. Despite this, Musk remains steadfast in his belief in SpaceX's eventual victory. His confidence is based on one important name, Starship. This giant rocket symbolizes the advancement of human exploration beyond our planet. So, what exactly has Musk revealed about the Zhu-3? What is the reason behind this high praise for the Chinese rocket? Most importantly, why does Musk think it can't surpass SpaceX? Let's discuss it all in today's episode of NR Studio. It's safe to say that China is building a more formidable competitive advantage in the space race than its former rival, the United States. This competition has intensified in recent years, especially with the rise of private aerospace companies adopting a strategy often referred to as copy and improve. Among all the companies being copied, SpaceX leads the way. Its pioneering rockets, the Falcon 9 and Starship, have set new world benchmarks for creativity and reusability. Now, China appears poised to combine the best aspects of both rockets into a single unit called the Zhu-3. Zhuche, meaning vermilion bird, is a series of rockets developed by China's private aerospace company, Landspace. The company has built and launched both the Zhuche 1 and Zhuche 2. Of the two, the Zhu-2 attracted attention when it became the world's first methane-powered rocket to reach orbit and successfully launch a payload, marking a significant achievement for China's private space sector. Building on that achievement, Landspace is now focusing on the next iteration, a reusable stainless steel rocket designed to compete with SpaceX's most advanced models. The Zhu-3 rocket has been in active development since late last year. The company has already achieved several milestones, including a successful vertical takeoff and landing test that reached 10 kilometers, as well as a static firing test conducted in October of this year. According to Landspace's schedule, they are aiming to launch the rocket before the end of this year and reach full utilization next year. What has attracted global attention is Musk's public recognition of the Zhu-3. In a recent online statement, Musk stated, "If they're lucky, this rocket might surpass the Falcon in 5 years, and after that, SpaceX will launch Starship." That declaration quickly ignited conversations. Musk, recognized for his audacious self-assurance, candidly acknowledged that Zhu-3 might outpace the Falcon 9 within a 5-year period, an unexpected admission given the Falcon 9's current supremacy in the worldwide launch sector due to its unparalleled reliability and reusability. So, what prompted Musk to voice such a claim? In a separate message in reply to a video showcasing the test of Zhu-3, Musk clarified his rationale. "They have integrated features from Starship, such as stainless steel utilization and methyl ox, into a Falcon 9 framework that would enable it to outperform Falcon 9. This innovation is precisely what renders Zhu-3 intriguing. Essentially, it is a blend of Falcon 9 and Starship." Regarding its specifications, Zhu-3 stands at 66 meters in height and has a diameter of 4.5 meters, with a launch weight of approximately 550 tons. These dimensions closely mirror those of the Falcon 9. Nevertheless, Landspace is already developing an extended variant named Zhu-3E, which will be 76.2 meters tall and have a launch weight of 660 tons. The rocket's initial stage is driven by 9 TQ-12A engines, arranged in a recognizable octaweb format. Similar to Falcon 9, the upper stage is equipped with a single TQ-15B engine, creating a nearly identical dual-stage configuration. The distinction is found in the ability to gimbal. Only 5 of Zhu-3's 9 engines can gimbal, while every engine on Falcon 9 is capable of this movement. The overall liftoff force of the initial stage totals 769 tons, slightly surpassing Falcon 9's 760 tons. Although the Merlin 1D engines utilized by SpaceX are technically more effective, the enhanced thrust arrangement of the Zhuche 3 allows it to operate at a similar efficiency. Consequently, Zhu-3 can transport up to 18.3 tons to low Earth orbit in reusable mode and as much as 21 tons when used in expendable mode, which is almost equivalent to Falcon 9's abilities.
Furthermore, the rocket features several recognizable elements from SpaceX, like grid fins, landing gear, a reaction control system, and strike wings. These components enable Zoo 3 to attempt various landing strategies, whether on solid ground or on a floating drone ship. As per Landspace, the rocket is engineered for up to 20 iterations of reuse, which could lead to an 80 to 90% reduction in launch expenses compared to traditional non-reusable rockets. Nevertheless, what significantly distinguishes Zoo 3 is its incorporation of stainless steel and Methalox, both of which are hallmark traits of SpaceX Starship. Stainless steel offers enhanced heat resistance, cheaper manufacturing costs, and simpler production in contrast to conventional aluminum alloys, or aluminum, for all my fellow Americans. Meanwhile, methane combusts in a cleaner manner, produces less residue, and holds promising prospects for long-duration deep space missions, including voyages to Mars.
By integrating the effectiveness and design of Falcon 9 with the materials and propellant used in Starship, ZU-3 aims to strategically combine the strengths of SpaceX's two top designs into a single spacecraft. This is why Musk himself admits that, with sufficient luck and accuracy, it might eventually exceed the performance of the Falcon 9. However, the fundamental inquiry still stands. Can it actually eclipse SpaceX? While ZU-3 is certainly a remarkable accomplishment, SpaceX is already significantly ahead in scale, expertise, and technological proficiency. By the time ZU-3 reaches its utmost capabilities, SpaceX will most likely have optimized Starship, which is much larger, more powerful, and better suited for interplanetary missions. In essence, while ZU-3 might reach the level of SpaceX today, SpaceX will already be defining the future of human space exploration. So, what are your thoughts on this ambitious attempt from China? Can it realistically challenge SpaceX's prominent position in the field of space? Please share your opinions in the comments and remember to like the video and subscribe to our channel for updates on SpaceX and the rapidly changing global space landscape. Personally, I find that the answer is quite evident. Zhuchai 3 marks a significant achievement for China's private aerospace sector, but it remains far from being a competitor to SpaceX, particularly when Starship reaches its complete operational capabilities. Musk himself acknowledged the promise of the rocket, but quickly contextualized it in a tweet stating that Starship is in another league. This single comment succinctly reflects the reality of the competition. Starship is not only the largest rocket ever constructed, it represents the inception of a new chapter in space travel. Towering at more than 120 meters and potentially approaching 150 meters in future designs, it overwhelmingly surpasses ZU-3 in both size and performance. To illustrate, the Starship booster is taller and heavier than the entire ZU-3 craft. When placed next to each other, the imposing stature of Starship makes Zhuchai 3 appear as a medium-class launcher instead of a contender. Next comes the aspect of thrust. The latest Raptor 3 engines from SpaceX generate 280 tons of thrust at sea level each. With 33 of these engines mounted on the booster, the total liftoff thrust for Starship exceeds 9,000 tons, with plans to elevate this figure beyond 10,000 in future upgrades. These numbers are not merely high, they are groundbreaking. In comparison, ZU-3 provides less than one-tenth of that thrust. It is an impressive machine within its category, yet it cannot compete with the raw strength and ambitious scale of Starship. Additionally, with power comes the ability to carry payloads. This is where SpaceX's commitment to ongoing enhancement truly stands out. As Musk pointed out, the upcoming Starship flight will utilize version 3, which is significantly improved over version 2. Furthermore, within a few years, version 4 will double the payload capacity of version 3.
Existing Starship models are designed to carry over 100 metric tons to low Earth orbit, while the upcoming V4 could surpass 200 metric tons. This implies that Starship will have the capability to lift 10 times the payload of the Zhuchai 3 at a significantly lower cost per kilogram. This isn't just competition, it represents supremacy achieved through scalability, creativity, and unwavering development. Reliability is also a crucial factor. SpaceX's rapid progress ensures that each iteration of Starship is not only more robust, but also smarter, managing errors, improving systems, and accelerating operational cycles. Musk's tenure, which has significantly improved, is likely to include reliability improvements, a crucial element for any rocket targeting regular reuse. SpaceX's extensive experience from over 550 Falcon 9 missions has produced the world's most reliable reusable platform. In contrast, the Zhug 3 has yet to reach orbit. Its journey to match the Falcon 9's reliability will be long and arduous. Another significant difference lies in the degree of reusability. While the Zhuge 3's first stage is intended to be landed and reused up to 20 times, its second stage is designed to be discarded, as is the Falcon 9's upper stage. In contrast, Starship features total reusability, encompassing both boosters and spacecraft. This complete reusability is central to Musk's ambition to make access to space as frequent and cost-effective as air travel. Each recovered and relaunched Starship significantly cuts costs, further advancing SpaceX's position. The recovery technique itself represents a significant advance that surpasses any proposed plan. SpaceX's Mechazilla mechanism, featuring a giant steel arm designed to catch returning boosters, is one of the most ambitious engineering ideas ever conceived in rocketry. While still in its infancy, the system has the potential for faster turnarounds, less wear and tear, and minimal maintenance between launches. Once fully effective, the system will allow Starship to launch and relaunch in rapid succession, perhaps multiple times per day, a feat no other rocket design has achieved. Musk's estimate of 5 years for the Zhug 3 to surpass Falcon 9 is more a reflection of SpaceX's pace than LandSpace's development. As Musk pointed out, it took them more than 5 years to reach Falcon 9 levels of reliability, production, or launch capability. This suggests that the Zhug 3 won't reach the current Falcon 9's performance until around 2030, assuming all goes according to plan. In the meantime, SpaceX will largely transition to Starship, leaving the Falcon 9 as a well-established legacy system. Furthermore, the Falcon 9's incredible achievements should not be underestimated. With over 550 successful missions and over 100 launches annually for two consecutive years, it stands as the most reliable and frequently used orbital launcher in history. That's it for today's episode. See you in the next time.